Punahou recently held its annual sustainability fair, a day dedicated to sharing sustainability efforts in the community and on campus. Punavision student producers were there and bring you this report.
Aloha, I'm Elena Kobayashi and welcome to Punahou's 6th annual sustainability fair. We're here with Carrie Morgan from the Luke Center for Public Service. So, Auntie Carrie, what is the purpose of having a sustainability fair?
Well, as you may remember, we have our 2016 challenges and our goal to educate students for a sustainable future. And so all across campus, there's educational activities that are happening in the area of waste, water, energy, transportation, and food. So this is a showcase of all the things happening K-12. It's the only time of the year where we pause and can learn from each other what is happening across our campus.
Today, I was just gonna look and I was gonna see what's sustainable and I was gonna eat Ono Pops.
My favorite booth would probably be this one right here with the cans, the can caps, because I think it's a fun activity which gets the young kids involved with it. And I found from my own experiences growing up at Punahou that the hand-on activities like this one back here gives more like a genuine meaning to the kids.
Well, I started making mosaics out of marine plastic from plastic I found on the beach from cleaning up beaches. I decided to use the plastic because it was really beautiful colors and a lot of it was bottle caps. So when I heard about the sustainability fair, I talked to some people who are working here and we designed these pieces and collected bottle caps so we could share in the fun of making things from things that would otherwise be thrown out.
So I'm here with Dan Meisensal and some of the members of Mr. Reed's fourth grade class. So what are you guys doing here at the Sustainability Fair?
We're just kind of walking around and checking out all the different booths and learning all about everything from, what are we learning, guys? We're learning about what?
Sustainability!
Water!
Sustainability! Waste!
Yeah, waste and all kinds of great stuff. It's a lot of fun.
I really like your hakule. Can you tell us more about that?
Oh, thank you. So, as you can see, this is the hakule station where you can make your own hakule, which I'm not really too sure, like, what's really the purpose, but I've seen that it's very popular. As you can see, there was, like, really newspaper, like, in a lay circle shape, and what you do is you have, like, strips of cloth, and you wrap it around, and so it comes out like this. And you can even have tail ends, too.
So what kind of products are you guys selling today?
We're most well known for the oat cakes, because if you eat one, it's like eating a whole bowl of oatmeal with flaxseed and fruit.
And where do you get most of your ingredients from to make these oat cakes?
Most of it comes from the mainland, because, you know, big goods, we don't grow oats or wheat here. But I try to put in as much local ingredients as I can, and I get a lot of it from farmers at the farmers markets that I do.
I tried the oatcakes. I like the banana and chocolate chip one.
So can you tell us what you're doing here today?
Well, we're telling people that you should switch to solar panels instead of fossil fuels.
And so what are all of these cool gadgets you have back here?
It's telling you that it's like generators that some light bulbs are very hard to light. This one, you can use four people and it still barely lights, but like CFLs are very, it can use one person, which is good.
So what's your favorite part of the sustainability fair?
The chickens. They're really awesome. There's different types of chickens. And they're just on the ground eating food, and that's what makes it pretty nice.
I think I just like how you can visit all the different booths and you can learn different ways of sustainability.
I really like how they have the Ono Pops because they're really good, and I like making this headband. That was really fun.
Through visiting a variety of booths, eating different foods, and talking to many people, we are able to learn about the many ways that we can sustain our bodies and the earth. This is Elena Kobayashi. Thanks for watching.